This video will show you how to navigate your individual modules in Brightspace. Once you've chosen a module from the Module Selector widget or Module Selector, you'll be taken to its landing page or home page. In each of the modules, you'll see the following common elements. The nav bar is made up of drop-down menus, which will allow you to track learner progress, add and import content and activities into your module, access and create assessments and rubrics, grade submitted work, and use the Erkund plagiarism checker, configure your module settings, manage your class list and enrollments, create announcements, create and manage groups, and use the virtual classroom. From the Help drop-down menu, you can also access 24/7 help desk support, email support, instructional guides, and the Brightspace community website. In addition to the navbar, you'll also see the content widget, made up of a series of quick access tiles for each of the units of content in your module, such as slides, documents, links, videos, and assessments. You'll also see announcements and calendar widgets on your module homepage. In the minibar at the top of your screen, you can return to your module landing page at any time by clicking on its title. You can also return to your Brightspace homepage by clicking on the My Home button. You'll see the same two notification icons and the personal menu that are visible on your Brightspace homepage. Remember, you can also switch to student view from the personal menu at any time. Within your modules, you'll also see the message alerts notification icon. Click on this and you can email any individual enrolled in your class list from within Brightspace. You may also email your whole class from the class list tool under the module tools menu. To begin adding content to your modules, click on the content link in the navbar, from which you'll be taken to the content area. In Brightspace, your module content is organized into units and subunits. These are displayed on a multi-level table of contents on the left-hand side of your page. The order of these units and subunits can also be rearranged using the grab handle. Before you begin adding content to your module, think about how you'd like to name and organize your units, for example, by theme, by week, or by activity. To begin building out your module, click Add a Unit from the table of contents and give it a name. Then either press Enter or click outside of the field to confirm. Your new unit will now appear in the table of contents, and you can begin adding content and activities such as files, links, videos, and assessments. For a full guide on building your module by adding content and activities, please see video 4 in this series. The fifth video in this series will also show you how to selectively import content from your migrated web courses modules. When you've populated your module with contents, you'll be able to access individual units from the module content widget on the module homepage. Here, each unit is represented by a tile. To open a unit, simply click on its banner image. Back on the contents page, you'll also see the module overview, where you can add a short summary including module aims, content, assessment approach, and key learning outcomes. You'll also find a module schedule, which provides a list of upcoming module events, such as assignment due dates. Selecting Upcoming will show events over the coming 7 days, while Full Schedule will cover the entire duration of the module. Bookmarks will show you a list of content items or topics that you've bookmarked from across the module. When you open a unit, you'll see a list of its topics in the display area. Click on an individual topic to view it. From here, you can bookmark a topic for future reading, use the previous and next buttons to move between topics, and use the slide-out panel to access the full table of contents. You can also navigate module content using the breadcrumb trail. Using the drop-down menus on either a unit or topic will give you access to a range of options. These include editing their properties, deleting them, moving their position, changing files, or in the case of assessments, grading and providing feedback. More information about these options can be found in video 5 in this series. From the Module Tools drop-down menu, navigate through Module Admin and then Module Information, and you'll be able to make your module active for learner self-enrollment. Here, you can also change the banner image for your module by uploading an image from your own device. Alternatively, on the module homepage, clicking on the three dots at the top right of the banner image will allow you to choose from a library of stock images provided by D2L or upload an image from your own device. For more detailed guides on adding content to your modules, importing and copying from your migrated modules, managing your class list and enrollments, and making your module available for enrollment, please see the other videos in this series.